How's it going, everybody? This is Nick back again from Respawn Studios with episode 2 of my Minecraft survival series. I'm calling it Spooksville for now. So let's get back into it. If you remember in episode 1, we managed to get a shack going with some... Oh, I'm on top of my chest. Okay, so we managed to get our shack built here with some torches, a bed, our two crafting situations over there, and a chest here that's pretty much empty. But I got some raw chicken, and I have a dog to go with it. So, let's set forth some goals for this episode. Okay, so I was saying before that one of my big goals today would be to get some glass. I've been thinking about it, and there are some other goals I want to get to. Number one, I want to get some glass to make windows. Number two, I want to make, probably number one, I want to grab coal finally, because I've been really short on coal for no reason. I want to get myself some armor so I can survive, because this is hard mode. And if I have time, I'd like to build a roof on this so it looks less like a box. Alright, so let's get to it, Mr. Purple Dragon. Okay, so right off the bat here, I see another dog. I want to grab him and a devil cow. Those annoying things, man. They're so loud. And that is a creeper. Oh gosh, that's a ghost. I didn't know what it was, but that's a creeper. Run away. I do not want to fight ghostly creepers. That's even scarier. If it was possible for creepers to be any scarier than that, like, weird green glitched out look, then I think that ghost creepers are worse. That's terrifying. Look at him. Look at his feet. No, go away. He scares the heck out of me. All right, let's get out of here. Alright, so let's find our little, spot that we dug in last episode. Ah, that thing is freaking me out. I feel like he's following me. Oh, it's gonna be all over the place. I really need some armor, or I'm gonna die. Alright, so, is this? No, this isn't it. What is this? Oh gosh, another cave. Okay, so we found another cave entrance. Here's our ravine. You're probably looking at me, like, watching this video like I'm nuts, like... Pretty sure I already found that. I don't even know. Wait. Is this a different ravine, or am I just, like, lost? I'm lost. Here's my spot. Okay. Sorry about the confusion there. The creeper, man, threw me off. Okay, let's see what we got. There's some coal down there. There's some coal up there. Coal never comes in ones, so... That's probably a safe bet. There's probably going to be a bunch behind it. There's some coal all over the place. All right. So where should... Oh, suicidal dog is here. Ugh. Okay. I want to get that coal right there because it's the closest to my current level. And so I'm going to pull out my stone pickaxe. And the reason I'm getting the coal first is because it is the gateway to everything else. I mean, I have all that iron ore that I was smelting with wood last episode, if you remember. And just, that's a bad scene. It's not efficient, and it's a waste. So, let me grab some coal. I really need to make myself a shovel. It's about that time. Whoa, I almost fell. Okay. Be a little more careful here. Get out of the way, dog. I don't want to knock you off. If you come up here, maybe I can get you to sit. This dog, man. And, oh, I didn't point this out, but I noticed it when I was looking at the video, after I made the last episode. Look at the stone, the faces in the stone. It's skulls. That's crazy. Like, of course it's the Halloween texture pack, but that's just really spooky. Whoa. Okay. Well, I got really lucky. I fell into a pool of water, but hopefully you don't do that. And that's terrifying. And that's terrifying. Wow, this is going to be very plentiful down here once I get it going. But I need to get out first to get myself some armor before I go spelunking. But here we go. And for those of you that don't know what spelunking means, that's cave diving. So I don't know if I taught you something or if I just sound like a pompous ass. So, got our coal. It almost killed us, but we got it. Let's see if we can get some more iron. I'm getting greedy here. Let's just stick with coal for now. I have enough iron. Alright, so let's get our coal situation figured out first. Our goal is to get back up to that ledge. Well, we might as well. I mean, there's iron all over the place. We might as well grab some. I don't think I have enough for... I think I had like 10. That's not enough for armor suit anyway. So, excuse me. The first order of business is going to be... I mean, a slight revision. First order of our business is going to be to get an armor suit. And the reason our plans have changed is because I saw that creeper and I got scared. So, we're going to make ourselves some... Oh, gotta go. I gotta go back out and grab a new, plans changed again. We're going to make ourselves a iron pickaxe first. So we're gonna go out of here and make an iron pickaxe and hopefully come back and grab enough. We'll make whatever armor piece we can. I really hate towering. I think it looks horrible, but I don't really have a choice because I don't have a pickaxe. I can't dig up to it, so let's tower up. Let's see, how far do I have to go up here? Alright, that's not bad. And the reason I'm filling all this in is eventually I'm as I just said, I hate towering, so I'm gonna eventually make this my staircase, probably. But, let's just work on getting what we need. Okay. And I destroyed my own way out. And the dog is following me. Let's go, doggy. Let's get out of here. Okay. Hopefully that creeper ghost is not right up here. Because I just hope he left me alone. He's going to be behind one of these trees. I know. Oh, is that him? Oh my god, that's him. Oh my god. I'm scared. Knock him off. Knock him off. Knock him off. Get off. Yes. Yes. Yes! There he goes. He's dead. And I almost died. Woo. Okay. I feel victorious. Alright. I need to build a fence around this thing. That I don't know if you guys noticed, but the difference in hard mode is crazy. The creeper was coming after me a lot more aggressively than like on normal or easy or peaceful. Well, not on peaceful, but on normal or easy. He came after me like really hard. He was running at me. Alright, so dog does not like this house for whatever reason. Alright, let's see what we got. We pulled out 16 coal. That should be enough for our purposes. I'll make another one pork chop. And then I'll move over to the iron. We have 21, so that should get me... that'll get me a pickaxe with 18 to spare. So I should be able to make at least my chest and legs. The two most important pieces. I'm not hungry. Wow. I thought I was hungry. Let's put our useless things away. I'm gonna like to make a bow later, but I don't have enough arrows. I would like to find a skeleton spawner. That would be great. If I could find a skeleton spawner and create a spawn trap farm, that'd be the ultimate. There's enough for our pickaxe. Let's make that. And I'm going to leave the rest to smelt, and I'm going to go back down. You know what? I hate to do this to you guys, but I really don't want to go down there without armor. That creeper situation really messed me up. I'm traumatized. So I'm going to go ahead and make my shovel here. And a lot of people say, why do you bother making iron shovels? Just make stone shovels. They're more efficient. But I don't know. I like iron tools. And I think it's kind of weird that everything, all the tools have like this green slime on the end of them. Like I killed a gummy bear. Ooh, pumpkins. Awesome. So I'm gonna go get those. I don't have an axe. Alright, well, I'm going to do what I was originally coming out here to do, and that is, while the iron is smelting, I'm going to get myself some sand for my glass, since that's one of our goals for the day. We're trying to get everything done within 2 days. I'd like to keep these episodes limited to 2 Minecraft days. That sounds like a good basis. So the sun is almost down, but I have enough glass to make my windows, I think. How much did I grab? I have enough sand to make my glass to make my windows, I should say. Oh, this is cool. This is like a nice little pool here next to my house. I got some. Let's see how our iron's doing. Are you gonna come in ever? I guess the house just isn't big enough. I can't get far enough away to make him follow me. Yeah, I need to make a gate outside. So I don't want a creeper blowing me up through the wall. I can't see through that door. The crazy demon door. Let's see what we can make. Alright, so I need an axe. I'm going to make a hoe just for later. Of course, I make a stone hoe because you never need a hoe that long. Buckets. Buckets are the most useful thing in the world. I can't express how much I love buckets. Whenever I go cave diving, I need to have a bucket with me. And preferably more than one. I mean, you would like to have 2. If you have 2 buckets and a water source, you can rule the world. You can basically, I'll show you how to do it, but you can make a, it's easy. Yeah, I'm gonna make 2. I know I need armor, but I need buckets. I love buckets. And who doesn't love trick-or-treat? I mean, look at that. Another cool thing to note is that these lights are green. And if you know about me, with the green torches and freaking out, I love the color green because, well, that's my favorite color, but the reason why I love green so much is because my name, my gamertag is Enviola, E-N-V-I-O-L-A. I don't know if I mentioned this before. You can feel free to add me, and I'll do co-op games and everything with you. I'm just kind of rambling right now, but basically, I love green because it's my initials. It's linked to my initials. So, of course, I've said before, my name is Nick. My last name is Viola, V-I-O-L-A. And so my initials are NV. And so that's kind of my call sign, is Envy. You know, green with envy, kind of a play on words. And there we go, iron chest piece. It looks like a... That should match me. Oh, yes, that looks dapper. Look at me. You can't really see, but... Yeah, look at me, I'm dapper. Got my purple tux on. Stunner. All right, purple dragon. Let's go to bed. We'll pull out our sword. Okay, so, yeah. My gamer tag is Enviola, which is just my first initial and my last name with an E on the front. And it also almost spells Envy, so I like that. Envy, of course, is taken on Xbox Live. I mean, duh. But, yeah, so that's why I'm, like, kind of obsessed with the color green. We don't need a map right now. All right, so our plans have changed once again. That's kind of how this is going. But our overall plans are the same. So, overall plans, get some glass. I forgot to put the glass in. Let's do that while we walk. Get some glass to make windows. Here we go. That started. Glass to make windows. Check. Get those pumpkins. That's been a big goal from the beginning because, you know, Halloween and everything. Let's see. I'm so scared that there's going to be a creeper right behind me. Ugh. Always. That thing freaked me out so bad. Alright. And the reason is because I have my headphones on and I can't really hear the game volume at all. So I'm just kind of flying by sight, not by hearing. So let's see. Alright. Wow, this area is cool. Look at that. This is really neat. If I had found this area first, I probably would have built my house right here on this little patch. But I can always make another little shack over here later. I want to turn this into a town that people... I mean, if you follow my series, then I believe you have a right to take part in it. And I want to include you and your ideas. And, like, so what I mean is, if you add me on Xbox Live as Enviola, E-N-V-I-O-L-A, I'll actually add a... I'll put a thing in the description with my gamer tag. But if you add me, I would be happy to have you come into my world, as long as you don't start griefing and blowing stuff up. you come into my world, you can make a house, you can give me tips, you can help me with stuff, and you can probably be featured on an episode as a, because right now it's just me against the world in here, and it's a pretty cool world. So if that would interest you, feel free to add me and just let me know. The other members of Respawn, I hope to get them in some episodes in the future too. So we got our pumpkins. Let's see, what were we doing before the pumpkins? We were getting armor. So that we can eventually dive into those caves and find some awesome things. Oh, another thing I wanted to talk about. I don't know if you follow the news with Minecraft, but there's a big title update coming out that I'm really excited for. It has one of my favorite items in the game. I played the PC version, of course, and one of my favorite items that I think really helps any world is hoppers. I think they increase the productivity of your farms by like tenfold. You can do awesome things with them, making like pipeline. Wow, look at glass. That's crazy. So many crazy things in this. All right. Yeah, hoppers, man. Awesome. So that's one big thing is hoppers. Another big thing is horses. Yeah, that's right, horses. If you don't know, Minecraft does support rideable horses. I mean, that gives a much better purpose to saddles. And that update, they've already confirmed it. That update is coming out. That's 4J Studios has tweeted that that's what they're working on right now. They said it might take a while, but that's what they are currently working on. Now, when they say it might take a while, that's the big speculation. Nobody knows how long it's going to take them to bring that out. But I'd say probably toward the end of November, early December. That's just a guess. But judging on the length of time it's taken their previous updates, I'd say that's a pretty good guess. Let's see. So it worked last time, so I don't see why we should. Look how far I fell when I fell down there. Wow. I got really lucky there was a pool of water right there. I'm going to do it on purpose this time. Whee! Yep. Ow, that hurt. Okay. Let's make that a little deeper, just in case we want to do that again. Yeah, so you probably know this, but yeah, if you jump down into a pool of water, I mean, you have to know this, then it'll cushion your fall. And you can actually use that to your advantage. Many worlds I've made have, like, fast descent routes. And my dog is going to drown. Get out of the water. He is suicidal. I got to name him, like, I got to run away and make him teleport. He's going to die. Grass. What am I going to do with you? Okay, let's see if we can put a little bridge here to make this easier for the dog. Okay, come on, dog. Where were we digging a second ago? Up here, I believe. Right, we had just done that, and we were going to go up to the second one. Okay. So I have my chest, but I really don't feel safe. I need to have a full set. And I really... People have mixed feelings on diamond armor, but in hard mode, I think it's probably worth it. Because you need every bit of protection you can get. I mean, look how much damage I took from that fall. That was insane. I fell really, really hard, and that was into water. Anyway, what I was saying is I make fast descent routes using water, and the way you do that is you would have... I don't know what I'm doing. You would have, like, a long fall, and then a pool of water that's at least 2 deep at the bottom. And the way I'd like to do it is... I'm going to break into a little tutorial here. The way I would like to do it is you would have it stop here. And a little fun mechanic is that water does not... signs stop water flow. So if you were to place a sign on this block here and have these two be water, and you were to fall in a straight line down, you would splash into the water and then fall out of the water. And I'll probably show it later on when I make something like that in this world, but just a fun tip. Of course, there are fun ways to ascend in water too, using the same mechanics. You can put water, then a sign, then water, then a sign, and you can just use that to infinitely climb. And I'll actually show you a little trick right now. It's kind of tricky to do, but... Alright, little explanation. I'm going into a lot of different things here. I'm all over the board. So I'm just going to show you a simple infinite water source real quick. It's one of my favorite things to build, and that's all you have to do. Is you have to have four water in a square like that, and you take water from the corner, and it instantly replenishes. And you could do that infinitely. So that's fun to know. Now that I have my water, I can show you a cool trick. And I'll use it in a second to get out of here, but let me see here. How much do I have? I have 11. Let's see, how many do I need for greaves? Like 9? Something? 4 for boots. Yeah, I'm gonna need a little more. Alright, so we've got our tools set. We've got our iron tools set up. So far we're doing pretty well on our goals. We just, we might not have enough time to build the roof, as I was saying. But, as long as we can get the other stuff all set and ready to go, then we should be okay. Alright, this is a nice big iron vein here. I know I said dig around before, but usually if you find one that big, you don't really need to dig around. You're probably only going to find like one, if any. But yes, if you ever find a vein, I know I already said this, if you ever find a vein of any material, except for emeralds, because emeralds can come in ones, usually materials don't spawn in one block. Usually it's more than one. One is very rare to find. So if you do find something like iron, and it's only one block, unless the world has cut it off, you want to keep digging in a corner to see, it could be in any corner. They can travel diagonally, so you can't see the second and third blocks. Okay, I don't know what happened there. My mic kind of screwed up. Yeah, so the second and multiple blocks can be hidden. I feel weird going into here. I read a cool, whoa. Ah, creeper. Get out of here. I just placed all my glass because I panicked. Oh, gosh. All right. So, do I have any dirt? Yes, I do. I should keep that out. I want to kill this guy, but I don't want to die. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to build a window. And that was wrong placement. There we go. Put that there. He should come down. Sorry about my little freak out there. I freaked out. All right, there we go. Let's kill him. Oh gosh. Woo. Stupid. Ha ha ha. Look who you killed. Yourself. I'm going to die later. I'm going to regret saying that. Wow. I feel really good about this seed. This is awesome in here. Look at that stupid guy. He's probably laughing at me like, "You used all your glass." Yeah, well. Screw you, buddy. You died. And it looks like it's getting dark. Oh, gosh, it's getting dark out. Well, there goes my two-day thing. Yeah, and I have to fill this in because I'm nuts, even though it's a cave. All right. Gravel out of the way. I just want to get this last thing. See, I get greedy, and this is gonna come back to bite me. I just tangoed with the devil in blue jeans and survived. And that doesn't make any sense, but whatever. It sounds funny. So I just cheated death with that creeper. And here I am trying to dig for more iron. I have 25. That should be plenty, actually. Alright, so I'll show you that trick really quick. I'd say this is a perfect situation to use it in. Oh, that scary green lava. This is a perfect situation to use it in because it's dark. I need to get out of here right now, and it's going to take too long, and there's zombies. It's going to take too long to go up my, like, long path that I built, or to tower out of here, all that stuff. So I need a quick route out. So let's see. My house is over there. So you place water above your head. You swim up the water. As you get to the top block, you remove the water and you place it again immediately. You do that again. If you time it right, aim perfectly at the wall and time it right, you should be fine. You can just swim straight up and do it again. That should be perfect. Okay. Let me out. All right, and success. Oh, gosh! Whew. Whoa. Okay, let's go to bed. These ghost creepers are scary, man. My heart is pumping so fast. I'm gonna have to fix that later. Let's go to bed. Oh my gosh. So, if you're following along, hopefully you're still alive. I can't believe that I am. Oh wow. Whatever happened to my dog? He's probably dead somewhere. I know they don't attack creepers. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, where is he? I miss him. I need to give him a name. But he's so suicidal. I feel like he's not going to be all around so long. Okay, so that's just one of the other many uses for buckets. I hope, that's not very well known, so I hope I taught you something there. Oh, this is a scary world. Let me get that armor pieces now. I'm scared to even open my door. These creepers are brutal. And you saw me click my stick off. It's because, I freaked out. Get out of here. Okay. Whew. Alright. I actually want to widen these windows a little bit. So I can see creepers a little better. I'm destroying my torches inside, I believe, but... Man, that... Like, I even just thought that was a creeper. Wow. This is... There's a creeper over there. Whoa. Right here. That was my face, and I survived. Alright, so let's, I know I said 2 days, but I really want to just get this done, so I'm gonna try and get it done in 3 minutes, keep this video at about a half hour. Alright, so we got some oak, put the gravel away, I'm gonna keep our coal on us, I'll turn these into jack-o'-lanterns, get that done. I don't really like this glass, it like blocks my view too much. Might want to make some more and turn it into glass panes. Let's see how many... Wow, the glass panes don't look much better. Never mind. I figured it would be like one little square section, but it doesn't really look a lot better at all. Okay. Calming down now. I'm really trying not to die in this, and that's really hard in hard mode, but I want to be as true to live as I can be with this. I mean, I'm doing live commentary, and I want to be as true to what is actually happening as I can. So, wow, look at those pants. That's ridiculous. All right, so pants, boots, one more. And hat. Where's my hat? Wow, this is gonna... It's probably actually gonna look really cool. Let's see. Helmet. Whoa. It's weird. Pants. And boots. I feel safer, and my guy looks kinda neat. Do the monster mash. Okay. So the last thing we were going to do is make our roof. I might just save that for the next episode. Well, in the meantime, you know what? This wouldn't be a complete episode if I didn't fix what that creeper did. But he also gave me an idea. Since I died and my water was left there, my initial thought was just to leave the water alone. So I have a fast way down, but there's already pools of water down there I can use. I would like to make them a little deeper, because that's a very long fall. But, for now, since I'm crazy, I have to fix every little thing. So, let's fix this hole. I know, so exciting, fixing creeper holes. I'm still like, I'm looking up at the horizon, seeing if there's any creepers. Ugh, those things, man. Brutal. Ran out of dirt. Doesn't look bad, though. Okay, so, is that a straight fall down? Yep. Okay. A thing with water, like waterfalls. I'll do a quick demonstration on the side of my house. Water will always travel into a hole, and if there's a hole, it won't go anywhere else. So what that means is, if I put a hole here, and even if I put the water four blocks away, like there, it'll go straight to the hole. Cool? Yeah, I don't know why that works that way, but that's just how it works. Like, path of least resistance kind of thing. Cool mechanic. But you can use that to do things like this, where this is what I would like to do over there. That's why I was checking. If I make a waterfall that goes straight down. Whoa, not that one. Right. Okay, so you have to change it a little bit. So let's say I did it this way. For demonstration purposes, why not? I'm going to have to clean this up, but let's say I placed it there. It would fall straight into the hole and be a straight line. Right, so I could jump off the side, and then after it's set, you can destroy all this. Oh, no, you can't. But apparently it doesn't matter, because what I just said, I'm teaching myself a lesson. So you can just leave it like that. And even if it lands on the ground, it'll still go straight to the hole. Neat. I actually didn't know that. I just learned something. So, even if it lands on the sides of the hole, it'll still just go straight to the hole. So you can use that to your advantage. Just place a hole in the bottom, and it will route all the water. Another awesome, awesome use for water, and the reason I carry water buckets around all the time, is because you can use it to mow the lawn. So you see all this grass. Let's say I wanted it to be a little cleaner looking. I could use it to mow the lawn. Just place your water down in the center and clean up. And it also, it's a nice fast way to get some seeds if you need those. You just pick up the water again and run around to the edges and get your stuff. Look at that. Nice and clear. So, yeah. Let's make that jack-o'-lantern. Where's my lighting? There it is. Ooh, they look cool. They look really cool. I'm going to turn them all into jack-o'-lanterns. They look really cool. I'm feeling good about myself. Alright, so next episode, I would like to, I'd like to do the roof, and I'd like to make a fence so that creepers stay out. Ooh, scary! Needs more jack-o'-lantern. Where can I put another one? Here. And here. Awesome. Okay, so next episode, roof and fences. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you like this video, please don't forget to slap that like button. And subscribe to Respawn Studios for all the latest tips and tricks, walkthroughs, gameplays, achievement guides, and hopefully more videos like this. I kind of want to wait until it's nighttime. Yeah, I'll end the video at night. So what can we do right now? Let's go chop some wood for next time. So, yep. If you guys, like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and hopefully I'll catch you next time. Let me know what you thought in the comment section below. And if you want to add me to your friends list, feel free. More pumpkins. All right, that's our next little thing. We're going to get these pumpkins. There's a lot in here. It's like they knew my seed and were like, okay, Halloween is in his seed name, so let's give him a ton of pumpkins. Awesome. This is like the best Halloween episode, like Halloween-themed town ever. Oh, I forgot to mention one last thing, and I'm glad that I have time to say this. I had an idea for, wow, I can't wait to go down there, like down these caves. I had an idea for this this series and this world. I want to make it special. And the way I want to make it special is, since Halloween is only relevant around this time of the year, and it's not going to be relevant later, I would like to update my world with each season, because I'm sure they're going to come out with more texture packs. And so this is just going to be an adaptive world that's going to go back and forth between all the different seasons. So when Christmas comes out, it's going to change. I'm going to change the name of the world from Spooksville to something else. We're going to keep the basis, what we got going here, and we're just going to redecorate. So we're just going to probably knock out some pumpkins and put in some candy cane or whatever weird thing they add. Candy cane torches, that'd be nuts, right? I wish I had more bones. Look at all these vagabond dogs. They look like people. Let's see. Well, I'm getting hungry. Let me eat. I wasn't watching because I got so freaked out by the creepers. All right, so, yep. Remember to eat your food. Eat your meat or you won't get any pudding. And look at all the little spots that go down into that cave. I guarantee there's a mine shaft down there, probably more than one ravine. Wow. All right, let's get back to the house so we can go to bed and bring this video to a close. So I don't always do Minecraft videos, but when I do, I like to do them like this one. Thank you for watching. Stay crafty, my friends. All right, and going to bed. I'll see you next time.